What is the task in hand? We need to rationalize the denominator of this term. It's got four terms in the denominator. Looks a little daunting, but actually it is not. I just wanted to walk you through questions of this kind where many of these terms have elements which are common but are written differently to start with. So what do? We're going to be starting this entire process by prime factorizing each of the terms within the root and then see if we can take things common outside. And then we'll end up with something which will look a lot more benign than what this looks. Instead about doing this, let's find the prime factors for each of these numbers. 14 divided by 108. 108, if you prime factorize it, it is a 54 into 2, which is a 27 into 2 square. Therefore, it's 3 cube into 2 square. So 108 is 3 cube into 2 square. Minus root 96. 96, we'll quickly prime factorize it here. I know 96 is divisible by 3, so this is going to be a 32. 32 is a 2 power 5, so I can write this 96 as a 2 power 5 into a 3. Plus 192, let's quickly run through the job for it. 192, I know it's divisible definitely by an 8. So 192 divided by 8 is a 24. This itself is a 2 cube. 8 is again divisible by 8. This is going to be equal to 3. So it's 3 into 8 into 8. Each 8 is a 2 cube, so this is going to be equal to 2 raised to a power of 6 into 3. Minus 54, which is a 27 into 2. 27 is a 3 cube. 3 cube into 2. What we are going to do is, every time we find an even power here, we'll be able to take it out of the root. So let's do that. 14 divided by cube. 3 cube can be written as 3 square into a 3. So the 3 square out of it will come out of the root as a 3. 2 square will come out as a 2. So 3 into 2 is going to be a 6. And what will be left out is with a 3 in the root. Minus, you can't take the 3 outside the root. There's only one power to it. 2 power 5 can be written as a 2 power 4 into 2. 2 power 4 comes out as a 2 square, which is a 4 into root of 2 into 3 is nothing but root 6. Plus, the 2 power 6 comes out of the root as a 2 cube. So it's going to be 8 into root 3. Minus, the 3 square and the 3 cube will come out as a 3. What will be left out is a 3 in the root and a 2, which is a root 6. So that's going to be 3 root 6. So we've got two terms which are root 3 terms and two terms which are root 6 terms. So instead of 4 terms in the denominator, we'll actually end up getting 14 divided by 6 root 3 plus 8 root 3, which is equal to 14 root 3. 4 root 6 minus 3 root 6, which is a 7 root 6. Incidentally, there's a 14 and a 7. 14 can be written as 7 into 2. This is a 7 into 2 and a 7. So let's divide the numerator and the denominator by a 7. So what we'll get is 2 divided by 2 root 3 minus root 6. This is something familiar to what we have done earlier. Quickly recap the process till now in a printed form and then rationalize this to get the final answer. What we do, we prime factorize the denominator. 108 is a 4 into 27, which is 2 cube, 2 square into 3 cube. 96 is a 32 into 3, which is 2 power 5 into 3. 192 is a 64 into 3, which is 2 power 6 into 3. 54 is a 27 into 2, which is 2 into 3 cube. So we've done this. Step 2, we're going to be taking as many even powers of the primes outside the root as possible. The 2 square will come out as a 2. Done. The 3 cube can be broken down as a 3 into root 3 square. 3 square will come out as a 3. So 2 into 3 would have added up, would have multiplied to give us a 6 root 3. Same process here. The 2 power 5 will split it as a 2 power 4 into a 2. 2 power 4 will come out as a 2 square. 2 square root 6 is what we have. 2 power 6 alone will come out as a 2 cube, which is an 8, and what will be left is a root 3. Minus, the 3 cube can be broken down as a 3 into 3 square. 3 square comes out as a 3. Root of 2 into 3 will leave us with a root 6. Combine like terms, so we'll get minus 7 root 6 plus 14 root 3. So 14 divided by 14 root 3 minus 7 root 6. Divide both the numerator and denominator by 7. So what we'll end up with is 2 by 2 root 3 minus root 6. Now let's rationalize this denominator by multiplying it with the conjugate of the denominator, which is nothing but 2 root 3 plus root 6. 2 by 2 root 3 minus root 6, multiply and divide it by 2 root 3 plus root 6 divided by 2 root 3 plus root 6. So numerator essentially is 2 times of 2 root 3 plus root 6. Let's carry it as it is for the time being. Divided by denominators of the form a square minus b square, a minus b into a plus b. What is a square? 2 root 3 the whole square. 2 square is a 4, root 3 square is a 3. So this term becomes a 12. minus root 6 square is a 6, which is equal to 6. So what we'll have is 2 into 2 root 3 plus root 6 divided by a 6. We'll cancel out to leave us with a 3. If you want, you can take a root 3 common from the numerator and write it as root 3 into 2 plus root 2 divided by 3. So where you stop is a question of how garnished you want the result. Let's go and recap this entire rationalization component in a printed form. We're multiplying and dividing it by 2 root 3 plus root 6, 2 root 3 plus root 6. So what we'll get is numerators 2 times of 2 root 3, which is 4 root 3 plus 2 root 6, divided by a square minus b square, so 12 minus 6. Denominators are 6, numerators 4 root 3 plus 2 root 6. Let's cancel the 2s. So what we'll get is 2 root 3 plus root 6 divided by 3.